You're watching UNICEF television. As the drumming picks up pace, more people join in the singing and dancing. For this small Indigenous community living along the banks of the Bangui River in a remote part of northern Congo, there is cause for celebration. A mobile team of health workers have arrived to vaccinate, treat their diseases, and provide them with advice on hygiene. Doctors from Medicine d'Afrique, along with missionaries from the Catholic Church, have travelled 5 hours by motorboat from Mfondo, the capital of Lukula province, to Moscow, a small village on the fringe of the forest. The Jongi, a magical spirit from the forest, appears from the bushes to bless the contingent. Despite the tropical heat, the singing and dancing continues at a frenzied pace. When the Jongi eventually returns to the forest, the music and dancing die down and the community gathers for treatment. For 10-year-old Albert, the pain of Sister Ancilla's jab of penicillin will soon be forgotten. He is suffering from yaws, a highly contagious skin infection that, although eradicated in many parts of the world, remains common amongst forest-dwelling communities and can be easily treated. For many Indigenous people living in the Republic of Congo, regular health services are practically non-existent. Mortality rates are high. Malaria, measles, tropical skin diseases are all common.
This work is very, very important to them, because when you neglect them and leave them, many of them will die. Some of them that are suffering from this sickness, after giving them this injection, when you come back 2 days or 3 days, you see that the wound is now going gradually until you will not see any wound again.
The challenge in many remote communities is the lack of health facilities, but even those that do have access struggle to get treated. Discrimination against Congo's Indigenous people is deeply entrenched. For the region's first people, the racial hierarchy of colonial days has continued unabated. They're perceived by many as subhuman and ready to exploit as cheap labour. In a makeshift desk, Rufin is filling out birth registration forms. It's no easy task for parents, who often have scant details on when and where their child was born. He often has to resort to examining teeth to guess approximate ages. The mobile health clinics, along with the birth registration, is part of a larger national plan approved by government and supported by UNICEF and its partners to help overcome the marginalisation these Indigenous communities still face. Under Article 30 of the Convention on the Rights of the Child, states have a responsibility to protect Indigenous children and ensure their right to enjoy their culture and way of life. This is Shantha Blumen reporting for UNICEF Television. Unite for Children.